Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I'm going to share some inspiration using the Tonic Craft Kit number 26. This is the last day this kit is available. If you haven't grabbed it already, make sure that you move really quickly. Tonic Craft Kits are always amazing. Every month you get lots of products and it is one of the kits that I highly recommend if you want to have a subscription. Let's quickly take a look on what you get in this kit. So you will get a mini stone drop in the color Chalk White and a mini crystal drop and the color is Wedgwood Blue. Now you will also get a small pot of glimmer paste, so the color is just gorgeous, full of glitter. You can apply it through stencils or directly on your project and the color is called Blue Topaz. Now this is a mini mica mist. The color is Silver Smoke. It is really shiny. You can spray it through stencils or just add a little bit of shine by spraying directly on your project. You will also get one of the pots of sequins from the Let It Snow collection, randomly one of the four pots. A whole roll of Baker's Twine and the color is French Blue. A whole bottle of the Tonic Funky Glue. Now this is a really big pot. You will have white glue for many projects to come. Just make sure that you unscrew the top, remove that plastic cap and then screw that top back on. I love this glue because it dries clear and it has a very fine tip so you can easily create very thin lines. In your kit you will also get a pair of scissors. It wasn't included in my kit just because it is a sample kit, but it is going to be included in your kit. The pair of scissors you will get is similar to this one, so a 5-inch detail scissors, but it is going to be blue for you. If you never used Tonic Studio's scissors before, make sure to grab one. You will absolutely love it and it is a must-have for your craft room. Now let's take a look at the stamps and the dies. Of course you will get the sticker that I always like to stick on my envelope. And inside you will find the stamps. The stamps work for winter cards since you have snowflakes and one of the sentiments that is quite generic, as well as for Christmas cards. On the dies now, you will find a couple of dies that match perfectly two of the sentiments, so you can cut them out and pop them on your project. You will find two dies that cut out the snowflakes. These two banners cut out lovely details, and if you use the outside border, it's going to cut it out completely, so you can mix and match them. But the fun part about this die set is that you get two different sets of ornaments, with lots and lots of dies to play with. You can use all those dies to create different layers, to cut out lovely details inside your ornaments. You can turn these ornaments into actual ornaments for your tree, or you can even create shaker cards out of them. Just play around with all the different dies that you get for each and every one of those shapes. And they also give you these two dies, one for each of the ornaments, that creates a little slit on your project where you can create a pocket and insert that ornament inside. And let's take a quick look on the cardstock that you get with this kit. Just like always, Tonic gives you beautiful papers to play with, embossed, glittered, foiled, some of them are shiny or satin, and you even get a mirrored one. Beautiful cardstock, just like always, that makes it really difficult to cut it out. So anyway, I'm going to start with the first card and I'm going to use this gorgeous cardstock to cut out my ornament out of blue. And then I'm going to use one of the sentiments from the stamp set, stamp it directly at the center. I'm using embossing ink for that, and then I'm going to apply white embossing powder. Now, although I don't show it on the video, I cut out that scene, I did prepare my cardstock for embossing. That's why I get lovely results. I always use an embossing putty, which is a little pillow that removes static electricity, and I will link that down below. So now I'm going to use my heat gun and melt the embossing powder. And I'm going to put my card together. As the top panel, I'm using this pattern paper that I had from a previous kit, but you can use white cardstock as well. I'm going to use the glue at the back and stick one on top of the other. I used foam tape at the back of my ornament to pop it on top of my card. And it is a very simple design, but it is quite easy to recreate. If you want to mass produce this design, it's not difficult. I'm using a piece of that baker's twine to tie a bow, and then I'm going to stick that at the top of my ornament by using glue dots. And I'm going to call this card done. This is a gorgeous cardstock, so for the second card I'm going to use that again. I'm going to do lots of embossing all over this panel, so I will prepare the cardstock before doing the embossing. So here is my pillow, removing static electricity, and then I'm going to start stamping the snowflakes. For that I will be using embossing ink, and you can leave it as it is. You see, you get a lovely tone-on-tone effect, but I am going to apply white embossing powder on top of it. So first I started by stamping randomly the biggest of the snowflakes, and then I'm going to switch to the smaller one and fill in the gaps. Now I am ready to apply my white embossing powder, and this is going to create a lovely background, perfect for winter cards, but it also works for Christmas cards as well. Now I'm going to stamp the sentiment, and I went with the one that says warm winter wishes. I'm stamping that with dark blue ink so that it matches the colors of my cardstock. And on my embossed panel I want to create a window where you can see that sentiment coming through. So that's why I'm using one of the circle dies, and I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine to create my window and then stick that directly on top of that sentiment. Of course you can turn this easily into a shaker card if you want to. To finish off my card, I'm going to add some mini drops using one of the products included in the kit. They are going to look as tiny little snowflakes, and it adds some interest and extra texture on my card. For the third card for today, I'm going to use this gorgeous glitter cardstock, and I'm using the circle ornament dies, one inside the other, and run it through my die cutting machine. I'm going for a shaker cut this time. So I'm measuring where about I want my window to be. I'm going to secure it down, run it through my die cutting machine. I'm using my tape runner at the back, and then I'm going to stick there my acetate. So this way I have created my main panel. And at the front I'm going to stick my little ornament. Now as you can see, instead of using my favorite Nouveau Deluxe, I'm going with the glue that was included in the kit just to test it out and see how I like it. It goes really smoothly, I like the fine tip, and it sticks really nicely and grabs very quickly, which is a good thing for me. You can leave this window as it is or add even more detail. I'm using the inside piece, and then I'm going to apply one of the dies on top. So you can see the lovely detail that you get, and on the other part I'm going to apply the same die one more time. So I end up having this lovely detailed piece which I'm going to glue on top of my window, and you can see how lovely it looks, just like a lace. For the background panel I'm going to use the glitter cardstock, so I am placing some of the sequins included in the kit, and I'm using my spoon by Nouveau. It's really handy when you have that. And I'm going to place directly on top my window panel, and of course I have foam tape at the back. Shaker cards always put a smile on my face. I love to see the sequins moving around inside with all that shine and glitter. To finish it off, I'm going to stick down my sentiment, and I stamp the winter wishes, which is the bottom part of the warm winter wishes stamp. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. I hope this video was helpful and gave you some inspiration on how you can use your Tony Craft Kit number 26. And remember, this is the last day the kit is available, so if you want to grab it, make sure you move fast. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.